out of here. Welcome to the Zed Channel.
I'm Rick. We'll be listening to some Zeppelin, and gonna go over a new car. Not just a new car, but it's a new brand to me. So why don't we just head on over to the table here, and I'll crack her open. What I have here requires some reading glasses so I can see what I'm doing. So what I have here is a Ford Mustang GT4, and it's Tarmac. And it's PF Racing, and this is from the Pirelli World Challenge in 2018, and sorry, it's probably a little blurry, but it's really not that bad. So what's cool about this, as I never knew this before, with Tarmac, they come in a blister pack that you can easily pop open, and it opens up and unfolds. This is a new blister pack to me. Now, what's interesting about this is it comes in its own protective blister pack, like you would get in the box of a mini GT. And the interesting thing about this is they do give you a box, but this box looks like a container from a container ship. And what I find interesting about this and makes no sense to me is if they give you all of this protective stuff to put to make sure that the car is protected, why would they make a blister pack so big that it won't fit in the box? That makes no sense to me. Why would I want a loose car rolling around in this box? I don't need a fancy looking box that looks like it came off a container ship. I want something that's useful. So right off the bat there, I'm gonna say Tarmac shit the bed. This is my first experience, and if they're gonna give you a box and a blister pack, everything should fit nicely. Now I see why they make that whole entire blister pack easy to get open. But with that being said, this car, this diecast, is an extremely well done piece of diecast. It's comparable to a mini GT or a Kyosho. But more of a mini GT than a Kyosho. They're all same on the same level though. So here it is. And what I do know about the GT4, it's based off of the Shelby GT350. And Ford Performance and another company got together and created this amazing GT4. There's a lot of carbon fiber material on it, obviously, which greatly reduces the weight of the car and frees it up for more go power. This particular car was raced in 2018, and the driver was Jade Buford, who drove this car, and he drove this at the Watkins Glen's race during the legendary Pirelli World Challenge. This was the GTS Round 7 event, as part of the PWC Grand Prix of Watkins Glen. So that's pretty much what I know about this car. I was hoping to see some actual video footage from that race, but I couldn't find video footage from number 55, but I found video footage from a paint number 40. But I wanted something that represented what I'm showing here. The details on this car are incredible. I'm just gonna bring it up closer so we can get a really good look at this thing here. You can look in the back here and see all that fine detail. There is so much going on in there. I almost want to take it apart just to show all the detail in the interior. It's unfortunate that you can't see it. But this car has been done really nice. Yeah, it's just, there's really nothing on the bottom. Actually, I was thinking of a Mini GT I was looking at earlier. I didn't look at the bottom of this. Sorry, I gotta put my glasses on here. Alright. I just wanted to read it to see if it was anything important I needed to share with you guys, or just saying it's made in China. But yeah, how about it? This GT4 is based off of the Shelby GT350. A lot of carbon fiber on a pony. That's some power right there. They've actually, from what I understand, PF Racing started getting into the mix of some of the stock car cups. Not sure which ones, but I did read somewhere where Mustangs are in. I don't follow NASCAR, so I am not too familiar with any of the racing. Not saying I don't think the cars are cool looking or anything, but and I'm not against anybody that likes to follow racing. I don't understand it or the point system, and it just, me personally, I get bored watching a car drive around in circle after a couple times. It's like watching a hamster running on a on a spinning wheel, seriously, and pull the hamster tires out on the spinning wheel and start spinning around on the wheel, then it's interesting to watch. Anyway.
It's very nice to be...
So yeah, this is what I got here. And I would like to dedicate this video to our good friend Joe from XLT Off-Road Bear, because I know how much he loves Mustangs and loves Ford. I hope what information I provided was as accurate as possible. I did do a little research before presenting this car, because I just didn't want to present the car. I wanted people to know a little bit about it, the story behind it, that it's not just a fantasy piece. It is a real car from 2018 Pirelli World Challenge. So anyway, I'm dedicating this to you, Joe, because you're the Mustang, you're the Ford guy. So, this is dedicated to you, my friend. I'm really enjoying this Mustang. This is my first Tarmac. Like I said, the only bugaboo I have about it is the silly box that they give you with it. You either keep it in the blister pack, or you put it in a box that it'll roll around in, or you find a blister pack and in a box that it'll all fit together in. But why bother wasting time and materials on something that isn't going to get used? I would like to use the box personally, but now I got to put it back in this, well, I guess it's not that bad. It's not the end of the world, but I would prefer to stick it in the box. That's what she said. Michael Scott, anybody? The Office? Anybody? Ferris? Bueller? Bueller? Anyone? Ferris? Has anybody seen Ferris? Alright, I think I was just gonna do this Mustang. I wanted to show for some of you that may not be familiar with Tarmac, as like myself, I wanted you to see how it opens and how it's presented and why on earth they give you a silly box that you can either put the car in or keep it in the blister pack. Aside from that, the car is extremely well detailed. It's built very well. No complaints or issues from me besides that box. That's all I got to complain about. That's the least of my worries. The next one isn't going to be put on the turntable. Now, my last video, I posed the question, what are some subcategories of things that you guys collect? And I put out two of the things that I like to collect. Subcategories. I mean, everybody knows I like to collect Chevelles, but I consider that as part of muscle cars, although Chevelle is my main focus in the muscle car realm. But I do have subcategories, and two of the ones that I mentioned in my last video were Texaco and Moon Eyes. So I found this. It's a 70 El Camino, and it's Matchbox Collectibles. Maybe let's just see if I move Memphis and the table out of the way there. Guys can get a good look at it. This move the camera up so you can see the whole package. I do collect Texaco, and The reason I collect Texaco is because it was an old derelict building not too far from me. It was an old gas station. It was still standing. There was no pumps or anything. It was just a building that looks like it was from back in the mid-60s. Like I said, it was derelict. It was boarded up, but you could still see the old Texaco sign on the building. So I took my Harley and parked it there and did a bunch of black and white pictures with my bike next to the Texaco building. And I got some really cool photos of it. And so ever since then, I've been just collecting Texaco stuff when I started collecting diecast as a tribute to my Harley. Because as most of you know, I'm selling that because I have to have hip surgery. And it sucks because I do enjoy riding my bike. But there's always more important things than other things that come along in life. But anyway, this is why I collect Texaco. And here we have a 1970 El Camino Matchbox collectible. For obvious reasons, I had to have it. I mean, one, it's an El Camino, part of the Chevelle family. And two, it was Texaco, so it was an easy purchase for me. But yeah, that's it. That's all I'm going to do today. Just a short one. I really just wanted to dedicate this video to the beginning of the video to our good friend Joe from XLT Off-Road Bear. Mr. Ford, as I like to call him. Anyway, you've been watching the whole lot of Zepp channel. I'm Rick.
The roots of that sort of music.
And
should be far more,
if you haven't hit that subscribe button yet, go on and hit that button and boost everything up here. More people to join the party, the more fun it is. So, anyway, to my subscribers, thank you again for hanging out with me while I show what I have on tap and while we listen to some cool music in the process. It's always a pleasure to share what I have with you guys, and I enjoy reading the responses, and I enjoy it. I enjoy this whole community. And anyway, you guys stay safe and be healthy. And I'll catch you on my next video.